Welcome back to the Gridiron Expert. We're continuing our ACC football predictions today, and today's team actually pulled probably the biggest upset of the year when they upset Clemson on the road in a 43-42 thriller. But this year they have a lot of inexperience and on both sides of the ball, but most people have them pegged to finish around third in the division. They are Pittsburgh Panthers. They have 10 returning starters. And although they have Max Brown, the transfer from USC, who probably will be a decent quarterback for the Panthers, they do have a lot of inexperience. 6 returning stars on offense and 4 returning stars on defense, which is usually their strength under their head coach. So, but this season, a lot of people have them pick third in the division. I don't think they're going to compete with Miami or Virginia Tech. But as I've said in my previous videos, I have them taking a major step back from their 8-5 record last season. Last season, they did lose some people. They had Nathan Peterman, who ended up being a pretty good quarterback, and then James Conner, the cancer survivor. That was a great story. He ended up having a pretty good season, but unfortunately, they lost their bowl game to Northwestern, a very disappointing end of the season. This season, I do not have them going 8-4. I have them taking a step back, so we're just going to jump into it. If you look at the schedule immediately, you can tell they have a very tough schedule. They get 2 potential top 10 teams in the first 3 weeks. They have to go to Penn State, who they beat last year 42-39, and then they have Oklahoma State, who they lost to 45-38 last season. So they can hang with them. We've seen that, but this is also a completely different team. I do not have them beating Penn State on the road. That's going to be too tough. And keep in mind, last season we didn't know what Penn State was capable of. That was the second week of the season. And everybody thought Penn State was looking at a 7 or 8 win season before they ended up making it to the Rose Bowl. So they're going to lose to Penn State here. Obviously get an easy win over Youngstown State early in the season. And then Oklahoma State, a team they almost beat on the road last year. Don't see that happening this year, even though it's at Pittsburgh, because Oklahoma State has 12 returning stars, including their quarterback and Mason Rudolph. He's probably one of the best in the Big 12, could potentially be one of the better quarterbacks in the country. And then they probably have their best wide receiving core in the entire nation at Oklahoma State. I don't think Pittsburgh, with their inexperience, is going to be able to beat Oklahoma State at home. That's going to be too tough of a game. Oklahoma State is the legitimate Big 12 title contender, if not possible playoff contender, if they can win some key games. So that would be a loss for Pittsburgh there. And then, after they face 2 potential top 10 teams, they travel to Georgia Tech on the road. We know what Georgia Tech's capable of. They have 16 returning starters. They're usually a pretty good team. This season, I do think they're going to continue to be a good team, probably win around, between 6 to 8 games for Georgia Tech. It's on the road. Max Brown breaking into the Pittsburgh system already would have 3 games under his belt against 2 very tough teams, but unfortunately, I do think they're going to go on the road and lose this game. Georgia Tech, it's not an easy place to play, and if this was the same Georgia Tech team from 2 years ago when they only won like 4 games, I'd be picking Pittsburgh. And maybe if it was at home, I'd be picking Pittsburgh, but I'm not doing it this year. And then they get a Conference USA matchup against Rice, kind of a little buffer there in between ACC play. That's going to be a win for Pittsburgh there. Kind of calm down. They're at 2-3, so things aren't looking horrible. But as I said before, you heard me talk about Syracuse. You've seen my Syracuse predictions. 19 returning starters. Very uncommon for a college football team to have that many returning starters. Their offense is good, and I said they need to be watching out for people that come to Syracuse. Pittsburgh will lose on the road to Syracuse. You remember last year they had that thriller. I think it was 76-61. So it was very high scoring, very exciting game. This year they have to travel to Syracuse though. And I do think Syracuse will make a bowl game. I do think their offense is going to get people fits. And when this team only returns 4 returning starters on defense, I think Syracuse might be able to run all over them. Same with Penn State and Oklahoma State. And then they get NC State at home. If there's going to be an upset per se, this would be it. They would need to beat NC State at home. This would be the game they could possibly win. I'm not calling for that right now, as you've seen in my North Carolina State video. I think they're going to lose right here to NC State. Like I said, that would be the game they would win, kind of one of those toss-up games. Out of the losses I've pegged them to have now, though, I don't see any that are really toss-up games. I don't think anybody would pick them to beat Penn State. Maybe Georgia Tech or Syracuse could be considered toss-up. I don't see it. And then Duke, this was a game I originally marked down for a loss for Pittsburgh, but I did a little more, I studied a little more, looked at it, decided to change my mind. I like that Duke has 12 returning starters. I think they have the potential to bounce back and get to a bowl game under Cutcliffe. He's done a great job there at Duke, but even though it's on the road, I'm going to give Pittsburgh the win here. I think they'll kind of, I like Max Brown as their quarterback. He didn't do great at USC, but he was also playing some very tough opponents there. His first game was against Alabama on the season opener. So I think he'll do some good things there at Pittsburgh. And then Virginia, a team we all know struggles in the ACC, hasn't been to a bowl game in years since the last one was 2011. Ronco Mendenhall is trying to build something there. Don't think they're going to do it this year. Virginia also has to travel to Pittsburgh, and I think they get a win there as well. Then a much-needed bye week. Now, they didn't get a bye week until November, so they had to wait a long time. They're worn out. They get a very short bye week, though, because they only have 5 days until they play North Carolina at home. I'm going to give them a win there. I think North Carolina's going to be fairly average this season, not like we've seen them before. But with Brandon Harris at quarterback, I'm not saying he's the savior for North Carolina, but I think that will give them a little experience after they lost Trubisky in the draft. At least they have a quarterback that's played before, and especially in a tougher conference in the SEC. So I think they will beat North Carolina, though, because it's at home. I like that. And then the last two games of the season, they need one win to make it to a bowl game, get to 6-6. I'm not calling for either of those to be wins because, as I've said, Virginia Tech on the road, I do not like that matchup. Even though Pittsburgh almost beat Virginia Tech last year at home, I do not see them going on the road beating Virginia Tech this year. I feel that Virginia Tech is probably more experienced, and it's also a home game, and Virginia Tech could potentially be fighting for a bowl spot at this point in the season as well. And then Miami, a team I have pegged to be 11-1. I think they're probably the best team in the ACC Coastal right now. And even though Pittsburgh gets to host Miami this season in the season finale, I know the stakes will be high for both teams. Pittsburgh trying to get to a bowl game, Miami still trying to finish at the top of the division. I think Miami will win this game at Pittsburgh. I think they're just too better of a team. And that will leave Pittsburgh with a 5-7 record. The key to this 5-7 record, the reason I have them pegged that low, is because of the inexperience. They're six offensive starters, four defensive starters. I know Max Brown's coming in at quarterback, but he's not the savior. He'll do good things. They're one win away from making another bowl game. They're not going to win 8 games. If they get to a bowl game, it'll be a very low level. If they're going to get to the bowl game, the win would most likely come against North Carolina State or maybe that Georgia Tech or Syracuse game, but I'm not calling for either of that right now. I do want to hear you guys comment and subscribe and like. I really would appreciate that. I love to hear what you guys have to say. Please continue to watch, like, comment, subscribe, and we will see you next time on the Gridiron Expert.